laws of God. What Christianity teaches you that God laws are done away with. What the Bible says, the law of the Lord is perfect. Read on. Converting the soul. That's how your soul gets converted. When you apply God's laws. God says, observe the Sabbath day. Remember it to keep it holy. But the majority of Jamaicans disregard that. There's been some deception. Read on. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. Another word for simple is stupid. How can we say that? It says it makes you wise. When you apply God's laws, that's how you become wise. Read on. Verse 8. The statutes of the Lord are right. And they are right. So these are the right things. We're going to show you some right statutes. Read on. Rejoicing the heart. And you're going to be happy. Because guess what you're going to realize? You are not Negroes. You are the children of the living God.
That's right.
You are literally the sons and daughters of the living God. But you think you're Gentiles. You think you're Jamaicans. We're going to show you some laws and statutes. Give me 1 Timothy 2 and 9. Because whether it be in your Christian churches, everyone chooses to do what they want to do, but they don't apply what God tells us to do. But the Bible says God's laws is perfect. Listen to this law. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel. So I'm looking around and I'm looking at how our sisters are dressed. Half naked, everything showing. But yet still they go to church. Well, listen to how God said women is supposed to dress. Read it again. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel. That's what God requires. If you're serving God as a woman, read it again for the sisters. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel. So God wants women to adorn themselves, meaning to clothe themselves in modest apparel. That's a commandment of God. Read on. With shamefacedness and sobriety. God wants women to have shame face. A woman is a feminine person. God made her that way. He doesn't want a loudmouth woman with shame face and sobriety. Not drunk, not high. Read. Not with braided hair. It's not all about the external. Not all about I just get my hair done. I just get my hair did. Not with braided hair. There's nothing wrong with sisters looking good. But it can't be all about how you look. Read. Our gold, our pearls, our costly array. But which becometh women professing godliness. So if you're a woman and you profess that you're a woman of God, you're going to go to your churches. God tell you how a woman should dress. Women who profess godliness, you're going to pray to the Most High God. But then you're dressing half naked. What type of madness is this? You're breaking the laws of God. Read. Professing godliness with good works. With good works. What is the good works that God wants our sisters to have? What is the good works? Give me that in Romans 7. Romans 7 verse 14. What are the good works? Or is it that you're only saved by grace? You don't have to do any works. If you're a woman professing godliness, you must have good works. Let's find out what is good. Read. Romans chapter 7 verse 12. Wherefore the law is holy. This is what the Bible is saying. God's laws are holy. So how can you claim to be holy and you're not keeping God's laws? Because God gives us his laws. That is why we're walking around half naked. You know what that promotes? Whoredom. Because that means a man is going to see you, sleep with you, move on, then he's going to see another half-naked sister. He's going to sleep with her. Move on, see another half-naked sister, sleep with her. That in the scripture is called whoredom. Are we going to prove that? Read on. And the commandment holy. The commandment is holy and just. God commandments are just. Read. And good.
And what?
And good.
The commandments of God is good.
Get me that Leviticus, is it 19:29? Shall I be the word without you, sir? God commandments are just and good. How are you going to know what is pleasing to God? You have to study the laws of the Most High God. But a lot of us don't know what the laws of God is. Listen to this. Leviticus 19 verse 29. Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
The Bible says don't prostitute your daughter. How do you prostitute your daughter? You have little girls dressing half naked. And there are a lot of perverts out. How can you do that to your child? Read it again.
Leviticus 19 verse 29.
Bring it out.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
That's what God says. Don't prostitute your daughter. Because when she dresses half naked, men is going to be attracted to her for sex. Not for marriage. For sex. But let's see how you prostitute your daughter. Give me Proverbs 7 and 10. So it says, don't prostitute your daughter to cause her to be a whore. Let's see how a whore dresses, as if that is in the scriptures.
Read. Proverbs chapter 7 verse 10. And behold, there met him a woman with the attire of an harlot.
So a woman can have a, such a thing as an attire as an harlot. That's how a whore dress. There are many sisters walking around half naked. Few sisters you can actually see dress modest. Look at that sister. That's how modest sisters are supposed to dress. That's what modesty looks like. But few sisters choose to dress modestly. Read it again.
Proverbs 7 verse 10. And behold, there met him a woman with the attire of an harlot.
So there met him a woman. And this woman dressed like a harlot. A harlot is a prostitute. A harlot is a whore. How does a prostitute dress? What type of attire does she put on? Is she fully covered? Or is she exposing her parts? Is she exposing her body? Does she try to get attention from man through her shape and figure? A harlot dressing half naked. But nowadays everybody's walking around like it's normal. Even in your churches, that's how sisters going to church dressing. Read. And subtle of heart. So now that woman is subtle of heart. Because what they say in Jamaica, she's trying to catch a man. Because women know that how they dress attract men. Men turn around looking at them. But they're not looking for you for marriage. If you dress like a whore, you're going to attract a whoremonger. Hebrews 13 verse.
Mark is honorable now. 13 verse 4.
But let's see what God honors. Because the wages of sin is death. What you, when you break God's consequences, when you break God's laws, there are consequences to that. God's laws are spiritual. Well, listen to this.
Hebrews 13 verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all.
That's not very popular today. Most people are getting divorced. More people are going around sleeping. God doesn't honor that. But listen to what God says. Read.
And the bed undefiled. Hebrews 13 verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all.
Marriage is honorable in all. God honors marriage. And he says your married bed is undefiled. Read.
And the bed undefiled, but whoremongers,
whoremongers. Let's see how God feels about whoremongers. What is a whoremonger? A whoremonger is a man who claims to be a gallus. He goes around sleeping with different women, turning his sisters into whore, and he's not marrying his sisters. How can you say you love black people but you won't marry? That means you hate yourself. That's not of the Most High God. Read it from it up again.
Bring it out.
Hebrews 13 verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all.
and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge. God is going to judge whoremongers. God is going to judge adulterers. But they don't teach you that in your churches. They don't teach you the laws of God in your churches. They're afraid to offend you. Because when you get offended, you're not going to be giving them any money. So the pastors are preaching for money. They don't teach you the laws of God. But the Bible says, whoremongers and adulterers, God is going to judge. Let's see how God judge a whoremonger. Deuteronomy 28 verse 61. Also, every sickness, when you sleep around from, when a man move from woman to woman to woman to woman, then he gets gonorrhea, he gets HIV, he gets chlamydia, he gets all manner of disease. Women likewise, you can get all manner of sickness when you move around with different sexual partners. That is God judging you. Read. And every plague which is not written in the book of this law. And some of us have been plagued, meaning some of us get some sickness. You're not getting rid of them because God has been warning you. Stop being a whoremonger. You may catch AIDS. You'll catch diseases. Every sickness that is not written in the book of this law. God judge whoremongers with plagues and disease. God doesn't like whores. God doesn't like whoremongers. Them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed. Until you be destroyed. We become destroyed as a people. Because a man sleep with a woman, he doesn't take care of his responsibility. Young boys walk in the street. You have young girls walk in the street. That's because of whoremongering. That's how you're destroying the land. But God says, give me Hebrew 13 and 4 again. But they don't teach you these things in your churches. This is what the Most High God says.
Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge.
Because God is the one who created man, and God created woman. God doesn't like whoremongering. God creates marriage.
That's right.
And God said marriage is honorable.
Bring it out.
But if you listen to your music, what they tell it to be, whores, gals, look at the posters and the flyers around you. It's the women they're prostituting. They're treating God daughters as whore.
That's
but
right.
God doesn't like that. God never honor that, and God will not honor that.
Bring it out.
Read it again.
Hebrews 13 verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge.
So you're wondering, why is it that I'm always so bad looking? A man is making a lot of money, but he can't seem to have any money. You know why? He has 4 or 5 different kids scattered all over the place. So he has never earned anything. God is judging him, but he doesn't realize he's not prospering. When you look at his children, he doesn't teach his children nothing. The father don't teach the son a thing because the father has become a gallus.
Bring it up.
That's what your music teaches you. Baruch 3:36. And then get Isaiah 4:6. Because why is God people living like this? Is this how a holy nation of people live? Then you have so much churches. That's supposed to tell you something about your churches. You're not learning about God. But listen to this.
The book of Baruch chapter 3 and verse 36. He has found out all the way of knowledge.
So the Most High God has found out all the ways of knowledge. The Bible teaches us that the laws of God is perfect. And God gave his knowledge to who? Read on.
And had given it unto Jacob his servant and to Israel his beloved.
You so-called Jamaican, you are the beloved of God. You are the children of God. God's children honor their father. You listen to what your father tell you to do. God give you knowledge, but guess what we do? We reject the knowledge of God. for the knowledge of man. My brother, let me ask you a question. Do you know what your nationality is? But most of our people, we don't even know who we are. That's why we're so destroyed. Isaiah 4 and 6.
Isaiah chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
So the scripture says, my people, Exodus 3 and 10, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Meaning we don't keep the commandments of God. That's why we are destroyed. We are walking around in blindness and confusion.
Read. Exodus chapter 3 verse 10. Come now therefore, and I will send thee unto Pharaoh, that thou mayest bring forth my people.
The scripture says, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Let's find out who is God, people.
My people, the children of Israel out of Egypt.
So God wants to deliver you out of your bondage. God wants to take you out of the situation that we're in. But we're rejecting God. Isaiah 4 and 6 again.
Isaiah chapter 4 verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
You so-called Jamaicans are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
Who told you you are Jamaican? Who told you an African? The same man that had you in slavery. But the Bible tell you who you are, but we don't listen to the words of God. But God said you are destroyed. Not lack of education, not lack of worldly science. What is the knowledge you are destroyed because you don't have? Your knowledge?
Malachi chapter 2 verse 7. For the priest lives.
The priest lives. You can't tell if your pastor is a true pastor, because God tell you what a priest should teach. The priest's lips. Let's see what should come out of the priest's lips.
Should keep knowledge.
Knowledge should come out of the priest's lips. But what is the knowledge? Read on.
And they should seek the law at his mouth.
And you should seek the law at his mouth. That's the knowledge of God. God laws. But we're not keeping God laws. We're not learning God laws. Continue. Finish that for me.
For he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts.
So, if you are a messenger of God and they're not teaching a God message, God laws, guess what type of messenger that is? That's a liar.
That's right.
Get me that in 1 John 2 and 4. Because you might think we're making it up. A lot of people love to say they know God. You cannot know God and not keep God's commandment. If you say that, the Bible is going to tell you something about yourself. You have been deceived. Well, listen to this.
1 John chapter 2 and verse 4. Verse 3. And hereby we do know that we know him.
This is how you know if you know God. Hereby do we know that we know him. Read.
If we keep his commandments.
If what?
If we keep his commandments.
If you keep God's commandments, that's how you know God. Read on.
Verse 4. He that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar.
God is calling you a liar. God says, any man, any woman that claim they know me, but they don't keep my commandments, they're a liar. You are a liar if you're not keeping God's commandments. But then guess what? Proverbs 7 and 2. You need to keep that commandment. Let's find out what happens to us when we keep that commandment. You're going to start to realize the things around you. You're going to realize that some things are not right. When you start to keep that commandment, you're going to begin to become wise. Why is it that most of our sisters are dressed like whores and no one have a problem with it? Why is it that most of our men are treating our sisters like whores and no one have a problem with it? How come in your churches it is the same thing, but no one says or do anything about it? That's all. What happened when you keep God's commandments?
Proverbs chapter 7 verse 2. Keep my commandments and live.
Start from verse 1.
Proverbs 7 verse 1. My son, keep my words.
So God is telling you, my son, if you're a son of God, you're going to be keeping God's words.
Read. And lay up my commandments with thee.
And you're going to lay up God's commandments with you. You're going to study them. You're going to know them. That's how you're not going to be deceived.
Read. Verse 2. Keep my commandments and live.
Keep my commandments and what?
And live.
That's how you become alive. That's how you start to live. If you're not keeping God's commandments, you're still in darkness. What are we teaching? We are Israel united in Christ. You so-called Jamaicans, you so-called blacks, the Hispanics, the Native American Indians, you are the Israelite that the Bible speaks about.
That's right.
And if you're worshiping the white man as Jesus Christ, you are actually worshiping the devil the Bible speaks of. So, many of our people are going to be celebrating Easter. In fact, normally on a Friday night, there's a lot of people out here. But they claim that today is Good Friday. Where is that in the Bible? What scripture says Good Friday should be observed? Who is making that garbage up? Colossians 2:8. Where is Good Friday in the scriptures? What scripture teaches about Good Friday? You can search the scripture, you are not going to find it in the Bible.
Read this. The book of Colossians chapter 2 verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
So God is warning us. He says, beware lest any man spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit. Now we're going to show you some philosophies. But before we show you some philosophies, get back 1 Timothy 2 and 9. So it says, beware lest any man spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit. Philosophies and vain deceit. These things they are spoiling you, which is not of God, but they are of men. What men spoil us? What men teach you what you know? In slavery, you are banned from reading. Everything you know, you learn from your slave master. That's the man that spoil you.
1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
So God says women, young women, should adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Read. With shamefacedness and sobriety, not with braided hair or gold or pearls or costly array, but which becometh women professing godliness with good works.
Give me that in Titus 2. Because why is our young women dressing like this? They're not dressing modest. They're not arrayed in godly apparel. But yet still they want to pray. They don't know what they're doing. Young women is prostituting themselves unwittingly. A lot of them even know what they're doing. But who should have taught these young women how to attire themselves?
Read that for me, please. Titus chapter 2 verse 3. The aged women likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
For the aged women, older women is supposed to teach younger women something. What should an older woman teach a younger woman?
Bring it out.
Read.
They be in behavior as becometh holiness, not false accusers, not given to much wine, teachers of good things.
So the aged women should become teachers of good things. You're supposed to teach your daughters the laws of God.
Read. Verse 4. That they may teach the young women.
The aged women should
church. The young women.
Women are neglecting to teach young women. That is why so many women dress like whores. Aged women should teach young women how to dress.
That's right.
Aged women should teach young women how to attire themselves.
Read it again, that they may teach. That they may teach the young women to be sober.
Young women, you need to learn to be sober. Don't get high. Don't get drunk. Men will rape you and then take advantage of you.
Read. To love their husbands.
A young woman needs to be taught how to love her husband.
A woman has to be taught how to love her husband. Because guess what? Some women may want to show, get up in man's face. The aged woman is supposed to teach her how to love her husband. Read. To love their children. Because now you have children, you don't even know how to love your children. Because children is having children. But the aged women, you're supposed to teach the younger women how to love their husband, how to love their children. Read. Verse 5. To be discreet. To be discreet. What does it mean to be discreet? Sister. Sis. Sister with the flyers. What does it mean to be discreet? What does it mean to be discreet? You're not going to be discreet. You're not going to be vulgar. You're not going to be just all out like that. A young woman needs to be taught to be discreet. Read. Chaste. That means a virgin. A young woman should preserve her body. She shouldn't be just giving it away like it's worth nothing. You should be chaste. You should be holy. You shouldn't just allow any and anybody to touch you. Read. Keepers at home. You're not supposed to be out on the road at any given hours at night. Keepers at home. What type of time are we living in? Yeah, Jamaica have one of the worst murder rates on the earth. On the planet. We have a lot of churches. We also have a lot of murder and crime. But then a lot of young women is out in the street at wicked hours of the light. What are they doing on the road at this time? Keepers at home. Read. Call obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God be not blasphemed. So this is the word of God we are bringing out to you. We're not giving you our own words, we're giving you what the Bible says. Deuteronomy 22:5. This is how you don't blaspheme the word of the Most High God. Well, now you're going to apply the Most High God into your life. Because a lot of us don't fear God. We don't fear the Most High, and we don't know that there is a judgment when you break the commandments of God. Read this. Deuteronomy 22:5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. What did God say? The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. A woman should not be wearing what belongs to a man. These are the laws of God you should be knowing, sisters. What is women wearing today that belong to a man? Pants. That's a man garment. That's not a woman's garment. Read on. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. Which princess, which royalty have you ever seen wearing man clothes? Neither shall a man wear what belongs to a woman. But how does God feel about that? For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God. So the Bible says, every woman that is wearing a man garment, every man that is wearing a woman garment, every person who is doing these things, God say you are an abomination. What does it mean to be abomination unto the Lord your God? That means it's something disgusting. God don't like that. It is this world that pushes that. Revelation 18:4. Because we have read before that we are the children of the Most High God. We are God people. Well, listen to what God is telling you. Revelation 18:4. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people. God's people are the Israelites. You've been brought into slavery for breaking God's commandment. But God is telling you, come out of her. Meaning, come out of your lying churches. Come out of the philosophies of this world. This world is blindness and confusion. Read it again. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people. A black man has no business bowing to a white man as God. God is telling you to come out of that foolishness. Read. That ye be not partakers of her sins. That you will not be partakers of her sins. Read on. And that ye receive not of her plagues. Because God is going to plague you. God will actually plague you. Amos 9:10. God is actually going to plague you. So God is telling you what?
He's giving you a warning. He's saying, come out of her, my people. Children of God, time for you to start behaving like God, children. Daughters of God, time for you to start acting like a daughter of the Most High. Sons of God, time for you to wake up. Read on.
Amos chapter 9 and verse 10. All the sinners of my people.
So now God is going to tell you something about his people. God people is the Israelite. God is saying all the sinners of his people. All women who is out of order. All men who is out of order. What is going to happen to them? Shall die by the sword. Because you know, you think you make your own life. God kill and God make alive. Numbers 27 verse 16. All the sinners of God people shall die by the sword. You lose that? Finish it.
Which say the evil shall not overtake nor prevent us.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.